Friends and relatives, we are gathered here today believing that God is present with us as we celebrate the coming together in love of Marcus and Lindsey. We remember that marriage is a time when a growing love is made public, when two people share mutual promises before God and before us. We join in prayerful support of them as they offer themselves to each other. We celebrate their joy, their love, and their expectations. We pray for them, the blessed presence of Jesus Christ, that whatever human weaknesses exist will be overcome by his forgiveness and his style of relationships. It is Jesus who said in Matthew 19, "Therefore a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let not man separate." Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for giving us life and meaning through your Son each day. We ask for your blessings and guidance on Marcus and Lindsey as they begin their journey together in marriage. We know we live in a fallen world and that marriage is difficult. We therefore ask for your wisdom and love that surpasses anything we find in this world. Even as Marcus and Lindsey have been drawn together in love for each other, now join them in a love born out of their desire to walk in your path. Because we know that your path is the only way to the abundant life that you promise. It's in the strong name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. Who presents this bride to us? If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way, it is not irritable or resentful, it does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, we prophesy in part, but when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I have been fully known. So now faith, hope, and love abide these three, but the greatest of these is love. 1 Corinthians chapter 13. I have read a passage of scripture that is often read at weddings. In fact, it was read at my own wedding almost 26 years ago. Yes, I'm old. I know I look young, but I'm really old. Even people who don't believe in God or know nothing of Jesus love this passage, because our society and culture are enamored with the word love. We say the word love all the time. We say we love our spouse and our families, but we also say we love widescreen TVs, football, and burritos. I would hope that this is not the same kind of love. Yet I suspect that we really don't know what love is, because we have, unfortunately, a allow movies, music, text messages, Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat, yes, I know what Snapchat is, to define our warped conception of love. Real love, the kind of love we just read about in 1 Corinthians 13, is the only kind of love that can sustain a marriage. You can't get it through emotion, nice thoughts, made for TV movies. This kind of love can only come from God, the one who is the source of love, the one who is love. It is a sacrificial love, a tenacious love, a love that is found in commitment and actions, a love that never stops regardless of emotions, regardless of romance or level of romance, or any other cheap imitation of love this world has to offer. Since this love comes only from God, you cannot express this kind of love unless you know God and you are in relationship with Him through Christ, the only way to God. Now, I met Marcus many years ago. He was one of my first graduate students at Laterna University. I remember well his dedication to his calling as a counselor, but more than that, I remember his devotion to his friends and his desire for quality relationships and the importance he placed on relationships. Now, he did remain mostly dedicated to his academic pursuits, but much to my chagrin at times, he tended to focus more on relationships, which is a good thing. This set an excellent foundation, I think, for his relationship with Lindsey. I knew that whoever God had for Marks would be blessed by his attention to relationship. It is indeed our relationships that make life worthwhile. Our relationships with God, ourselves, and others are the very foundations of life. God has blessed Marcus and Lindsey with a relationship based on Him and a dedication to grow in that relationship. I look forward to see how Marcus and Lindsey, in response, will now bless others, because that's the nature of blessing. We don't just keep blessings for ourselves. We extend the same blessing to others. So now that God has blessed you together, you in turn bless others as you walk through life. Okay, here comes the declaration. You ready? Marcus, will you have Lindsey to be your wife, to live with her, respect her, and love her as God intends, with the promise of faithfulness, tenderness, and helpfulness, as long as you both shall live? Lindsey, will you have Marcus to be your husband, to live with him, respect him, and love him as God intends, with the promise of faithfulness, tenderness, and helpfulness, as long as we both shall live? Okay, now for the balance. Okay, Marcus, repeat after me. Don't worry, I'm going to go slow. Okay. I, Marcus, take you, Lindsey, to be my wife, to live with you, and to love you, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, from this time forward, until death separates us. I promise to be understanding, forgiving, and seeking of your happiness as we grow together in God's grace. Lindsey, repeat after me. I, Lindsey. Take you, Marcus, to be my husband, to live with you, and to love you, for better or for worse, okay, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, from this time forward, until death separates us. I promise to be understanding, forgiving, and seeking of your happiness as we grow together in God's grace. May it Who has the reins? And then out to the cross. These rings are a circle, a long-held symbol of never-ending love that you have promised to each other. Take it, place it on her finger, and repeat after me. I give you, my best friend, this ring to wear as a sign of my promise to continue to love and grow with you from this day forward. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you so much for bringing everyone here today. We thank you for this beautiful venue. We thank you for the beautiful day. Most of all, Lord, we thank you for Marcus and Lindsey, for bringing them together through various circumstances and relationships and people. You brought them here to this point. We thank you for that, Lord. Lord, I pray that they continue their life together, that you will bless them and watch over them, to lay your hands upon them, to wrap them in your love and grace each day. It's in Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. Marcus and Lindsey will now take their first communion together. Communion has a long and deep tradition in the church. In the evangelical tradition, communion symbolizes the sacrifice that Jesus made for the redemption of our fallen nature. Marcus and Lindsey have chosen to engage this communion as both a symbol of Jesus' sacrifice for their sins and to extend this need for forgiveness and redemption in their marriage. All marriages must practice sacrifice and forgiveness for the marriage to remain healthy and growing.
Here I am, King.
his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. And the Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. And may you always love Jesus above all else. Since Marcus and Lindsey have exchanged promises of mutual love and have professed before those of us gathered here, they will live together as understanding, grace-filled persons in God's sight. I now declare they are husband and wife in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Now the part they've been patiently waiting for all day. Marcus, you may now kiss your bride as an outward sign of your commitment to one another.
Apologize. I forgot to sit you down. I'm a counselor. I was actually testing your intelligence, and it didn't go very well. So, Dr. and Mrs. Turner request your presence at the reception. The wedding parties will stay behind for a little while to take pictures, so go ahead and make your way to that building right there. Thank you for coming.